Hallelujah. Good evening, everyone. This is Bishop Mel. We're now in a portion where we can share with you the Holy Word of God. Title of the message tonight is, I Made You a Watchman. I Made You a Watchman. Our text tonight came from the book of Ezekiel, chapter 2, and Ezekiel, chapter 3. Let me just open up in prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you once more, oh God, that you can gather your people on this prayer line, God. Lord, oh God, we give you praise. We give you glory, God. Thank you, oh God, for this moment that you are in the midst of us. Lord, we choose to accept each succeeding moment as a gift from your hands, forgetting those which are behind and reaching forth unto those things which are before us, Lord. So tonight we press forward the mark for the prize of high calling of God in Christ Jesus. Lord, we give you praise tonight, O God, for this ministry of intercession, God. Lord, we give you praise, O God, that you can teach us tonight. We want to be able to stand in the gap before you, God. And we want to lift up others to you in prayer, faithfully interceding for them in your presence. Lord, we know that you have posted us as a watchman on your walls, and we will never be silent day or night. And we will call on you, Lord, and we will give ourselves no rest, and we will give you no rest until you establish us. You establish your people, oh God, on this prayer line live. So tonight we just want to give you all the glory, the praises, and the honor in Jesus' precious holy name. The title of the message again tonight is, I Made You a Watchman. Our text tonight came from the book of Ezekiel. Let me just read chapter 3, verse 17. Ezekiel chapter 3, verse 17. It says here, Son of man, I have made you a watchman for the house of Israel. So hear the word I speak and give them warning from me. You know, God's desire is for people to know him. That's why tonight's message comes through many times in the book of Ezekiel, through the prophet's use of the statement that they will know that I am the Lord. So this praise, or one like it, occurs about almost 65 times in the book. So the frequent use of this praise strongly suggests that God will do whatever is needed for people to know him, including, listen to this, including to know him, including allowing bad time to come to them. And God seemed to use bad time as a last resort after other methods failed to produce any lasting change in the people of Israel or an individual. That's why God called Ezekiel and sent him to deliver a message of coming doom. You know, the book of Ezekiel details the message of God's judgment to get the attention of the people. To fulfill God's plan, the prophet needed great holy boldness and courage that could only come through total dependence on God himself. So from the call of Ezekiel, we learn that God calls and enables his people to serve him without fear and with boldness. We need to respond to this call with courage starting tonight. You know, people are not often brave, you know, by nature, probably including you and me on this prayer line. You know, the instinct toward self-preservation generally is much stronger than to risk one's safety to get involved in a very dangerous situation. However, situations sometimes prompt great courage to be displayed by ordinary people like you and me. So people trapped in a house fire as an example, or probably a child in danger or an ailing spouse, can all set the stage for what? Courage and boldness to be displayed. So the prophet Ezekiel gave us an example tonight of holy boldness and courage. So Ezekiel's calling was not to a ministry in which people would, you know, experience life-altering change or divine blessing. Instead, listen to this, he was chosen to announce the destruction of Jerusalem and the temple. So God told Ezekiel that his fellow Israelites would not respond favorably to his messages. So as a result, Ezekiel would need courage, boldness to stand against a rebellious people here. So by understanding Ezekiel's call, you will know that God calls and enable his people to serve him without fear and with holy boldness. So if you want to go up in your Bible, the book of Ezekiel chapter 2, verses 1 to 7, for the sake of time, just open it and follow me on this. Verses 1 to 7. Here Ezekiel prophesied during the worst and tumultuous time in Israel. So the kingdom of Judah was near total collapse. The Babylonians were deporting Israelites to Babylon. So Ezekiel was among those taken prisoner. That's why from Babylon, Ezekiel's prophetic mission was to inform the Israelites that their sin was the cause of their nation's collapse. So this unpopular message would not be easy to deliver. Even in this day and age, it's hard to deliver the coming doom. You can find that in verses 3 to 6. So before Ezekiel called to prophetic ministry, he had a tremendous spiritual experience. Go to Chapter 1, verses 3 to 28. So it was accompanied with manifestation of God's presence in glory. That's why many people have wonderful spiritual experience with God. They usually run to various church services, seminars, crusade, conferences, trying to relive those experiences. They run for those things. They think the experience is the goal, but it is not. Fulfilling the mission is the goal, not pursuing supernatural experience. So based on the response to Ezekiel ministry, what happened here? Many would say his ministry was not very effective, but the effectiveness of a ministry, listen to this, must not be based solely on the response of the people. The children of Israel were hostile to Ezekiel's message here. Yet, he was faithful to proclaim God's word. So this reminds us, you and me as Christians, to find satisfaction in obeying God rather than the response of the people. Sometimes Christian service, you know, like healing, salvation, deliverance, receive little affirmation from the people. That is why Ezekiel's mission was to present a difficult message here. Because of the rebellious and stubbornness of the people, three times in verse 6, God told Ezekiel not to be afraid. In verse 6, it says here, "You and you, son of man, do not be afraid of them or their words. Do not be afraid, though briars and thorns are all around you and you live among scorpions. Do not be afraid of what they say or terrified by them, though they are rebellious people the time. So here we could see that there are three things that that the Lord has encouraged him. Do not be afraid. Fear would be the main obstacle to overcome to fulfill his ministry here. Yet Ezekiel's name, which means, by the way, God makes strong. That's what Ezekiel's name meaning. God makes strong. So would remind him to find strength in God. So God remind Ezekiel to find his strength only from God. That's why he said, do not be afraid three times in the book of Ezekiel chapter 2 verse 6. That's why fear, a natural human response to what? To rejection. It can hinder a person's willingness to serve God. If you have fear, you have no boldness, it will hinder your serving God. But you can find that God will enable you to serve him without fear if God is with you. Go to Ezekiel chapter 2 verses 8 to chapter 3 verse 9. Just open your Bible for the sake of time. Here, before he could present God's word to fellow Israelites in exile, verse 8 of Ezekiel chapter 2, Ezekiel had to receive the message. He has to hear from God, the call from God. So it was not enough for him to have an experience with God. He needed God's message within him to proclaim it, to fulfill the mission. He has to hear from God before fulfilling the mission. So in a continuation of the vision described in chapter 1 of Ezekiel, remember, if you're a student of the Bible, received a scroll from God to eat. Although the words on the scroll were words of mourning and lament and woe, verse 10 of chapter 2, they tasted sweet as honey to Ezekiel when he ate the scroll. So God's word is sweet to the soul of a person. That's why you have to proclaim the word of God that would be sweet to the soul of a person. So it is knowing God and his word will bring joy to a person, even when the message is what? A doom message. A serious message, as the one Ezekiel proclaiming as a watchman here. So after a call or dramatic call and receiving the word from God, Ezekiel now could speak to people in great need of hearing from God. Like Ezekiel, you and I, all Christians, are called to God's service. So here he calls you to be a witness of Christ. Once you got saved, you are called to be a witness for Christ. You may never be asked to speak to a multitude of people, but listen to this, but you can and should share your testimony, what God has done for your life and what God has done for others, so that you can share that to others and open up an opportunity for you to do so. That's why Ezekiel was called to home mission among his own people. Can you imagine this? He didn't go to some other country or some other nation. He was called to home mission among his own people. You know, in our time or in modern time, Christians seem to regard the call to go to a foreign land as more important than a call to ministry among one's people in the community. So why should one be any more important than the others? You know, there is a great need everywhere, whether it's in your home, in your community, or abroad, there is a great need everywhere. So here in his case, Ezekiel would not need to learn a new language. Can you imagine? He don't need to have a degree in theology. Verse 5 and 6. Ezekiel would speak God's word to his own people by the help of the Holy Spirit. But God warned him it would be a difficult task, for the people were hard hearted. They don't want to accept the message of gloom and doom. No, but God made Ezekiel a watchman for the coming doom. But God would make him tough enough to handle the hard times and the hard people. You know, God would help him overcome any fear of their response so he could speak for God about the national or the nation calamity they were facing in coming. That's why tonight, if you want to go to Ezekiel chapter 3, verses 10 to 15, okay? Just open your Bible to a new chapter. Ezekiel chapter 3, verses 10 to 15. To speak a message for God is an act that cannot be done through human strength and effort. You cannot do it. Only through God that you can speak the message of God to a hostile nation. That's why often people resist God's message and the messenger. And this can result in fear to a servant of God. You know, the messenger must rely on the power of the Holy Spirit. That's why you need the power of the Holy Spirit to bring the message of God. In the book of Acts, chapter 1, verse 8, when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, you will have the power to be witness and witnesses to all nations. So the Spirit works in the lives of God's people, to you and me. Without the Holy Spirit, it's impossible for you to bring the message of God and giving those who would otherwise be reluctant to speak. They need the power of the Holy Spirit, regardless of the outcome. Ezekiel was to speak whether the Israelites listen or not. Doesn't matter. All he has to do is to proclaim the gospel and give the message to the coming doom. You can find that Ezekiel chapter 3, verse 10 to 11. That's why after exhorting him to speak God's message, the Spirit lifted Ezekiel up and carried him through heavenly places in a vision. Ezekiel got one last glimpse of heavenly things before beginning his mission. That's why as Ezekiel returned from receiving the vision to the reality of it, of the exile among the Israelites, anticipation of the mission began to set in on him. So he became bitter here. Verse 14, he became angry and God's strong hand on him as a watchman. You know, sin does not just cause pain. If you have sinned, it will not just cause pain or guilt for the person who committed it. It hurts God also. When you commit sin, it hurts God. You know, rebellion angers God. If you have a rebellious heart, it angers God. Ezekiel would need to feel angry about the rebellion and sin of the people. That's why until Christian, you and me feel the same kind of anger God feels for sin, they will not have what? They will not have inward compulsion to do anything about it. They will not listen to the message. You know, the Holy Spirit who empowers believers, as in the book of Acts, chapter 1, verse 8, also helps them to see things from God's perspective. You know, Christians today need an experience with God while they also grow in their knowledge of God's Word. You must have the testimony of what God done to your life. So here, after the vision and the call of Ezekiel, Ezekiel was to speak to men who had lost, what, their palms, women who had been separated from children while being transported to Babylon, and children who did not know the God of Israel because their parents raised them to pray to the idols. That's why Ezekiel saw the reality of a sinful world, and that's what we see right now in this age. We see the reality of a sinful world. That's why God made him a watchman, and God will also make us a watchman in this last day, a last hour of the last day. And he saw the reality of a sinful world that he knew would be filled with angry people when he spoke the message. When you speak the message, when you minister the message of God, they will be angry with you. That's what happened to Ezekiel. He also knew the reality of God and that the power of God's Spirit was on him when he bring the message to the people. So tonight, although he was angry here in our text, In the book of Ezekiel, chapter 2 and verse 3, although he was angry at Israel, God cared about them enough to send warning message to them through one of his servants, Ezekiel. The painful message told them why things were falling apart. Many people are in spiritual bondage even now, living in rebellion far away from God. Just as God cared about the exile in Ezekiel's day, God cares about you and me in this day and age. So God may want to use you and me in this last day to tell them why their family is falling apart, why there's so much failing in the life of the people, why children are rebelling against their parents, why there's so much drug addiction, adultery, fornication, lewdness. The message may hurt them. And they may not respond immediately, but it will set the stage for the hope that God has to offer them to save them. Ezekiel came from a priestly family and had probably become familiar with temple worship and even the laws of God. Yet he needed his own, calling. He needed to hear from God. He needed to meet God for himself. To be a watchman for the people. You need to hear from God to be watchman to the people of today. To know what God wanted him to do, Ezekiel has to hear that, especially since he lived in the dark days for the people of Israel, and that's what we are today. We are in the dark age. The nature of his call corresponds to the drastic nature of his mission and message to fulfill as a watchman. You know, believers today who grow up familiar with the things of God also need to meet God for themselves and receive a personal calling. The experience of the parents will set the tone for the next generation. You should minister to your own children because they are the next generation, but it will not be enough to lead this next generation into service. Ezekiel's personal experience with God enabled him to provide valuable service to God's kingdom at a critical time in Israel history. So tonight, my question is, God wants to make you a watchman. Are you ready to rise to the challenges of today? The call of God to you is to be a watchman. Are you one called today to proclaim the gospel? And this is the question to everyone on this prayer line live. Hallelujah. Let God use you today, starting tonight, as a watchman. There will be coming doom if the people will not seek the face of God. If the people will not turn away from their sin and their wickedness, there will be coming doom. But thanks be to God, people will respond tonight as a watchman for his glory and for his honor in Jesus' precious holy name. Amen. Let me just close up in prayer. Heavenly Father, tonight we come boldly before your throne of grace because we know that in your presence we will obtain mercy and find grace to help in our time of need. We need greater boldness tonight and courage, even in our praying, even in our witnessing, even in our living. Thank you, God, for hearing our prayer tonight. This is the confidence we have in you. When we ask anything according to your will, we know you hear us, and we know you will give us the petition we requested of you as long as they are in accordance of your will and in your word. Show us tonight how to become as bold as a lion, as a lion in all aspects of our life. Help us to open our mouth boldly to be your watchman tonight. We are not ashamed of your gospel, Lord, because we know it is your power unto salvation to all those who will believe. And we want to speak boldly and without fear in your behalf. Thank you, Lord, for divine empowerment from the Holy Spirit that comes through the impartation of your presence, God. With boldness and courage as a watchman of this last day, Lord, so that we will always be your witness everywhere we go in this last day. Because of the spiritual resources and power you have given us, we know that we will never be ashamed in anything, but will with all boldness, let Christ be magnified in our lives today. For us to live in Christ and to die is gain. Thank you, God, for giving us great boldness in the faith which is in Christ Jesus. In Him, our love is made perfect, and therefore, we have boldness to face any situation, any circumstances, Lord, in this coming day. For you have made us a watchman. In Jesus' precious holy name. Amen. Hallelujah.